Network troubleshooting using Wireshark.
So today what we're going to be talking about is troubleshooting two-way TLS. Now, there is another video on the channel about troubleshooting TLS connections, specifically handshakes. That video is still relevant to everything we're going to cover today. And we're not going to recover the basic troubleshooting steps you should take within TLS. What we are going to cover, though, is the additional step that's involved with two-way TLS that makes it two-way, and then how to troubleshoot and diagnose that. So what is two-way TLS? Two-way TLS is an additional step in the TLS handshake where usually you connect to a server. The server gives you a certificate, and then you validate the certificate, and then you do all sorts of other exchanges, and then the connection goes through. With two-way TLS, that's considered one-way TLS. With two-way TLS, you connect to the server the same way, you validate the server certificate, but then you are required as a sender to send a certificate and have that validated. So you're being validated as well as by the server, as the server is being validated by you. So what we're going to do is, this is a wide open capture. I'm using the website badssl.com for testing. I'll put the link in the description of the video, but there's one stream in here that I want to pick out. So I'm going to do an IP filter, IP ADDR. Okay. Now there's some additional traffic up here, but there's a stream here, which is my stream of interest. So here's where we're going to start. I'm going to mark that packet. My host here connects to the site. There's a three-way handshake. Client hello, server hello comes back. That means that, as you remember before, my client hello was accepted by the server. Server hello comes back. The server sends a certificate. Also, server key exchange. Now remember again, if we get past this point, usually it means the certificate from the server is valid. But there's an additional step here. Server key exchange is typical. Server hello done is typical, but here is an additional message. It's a certificate request. And if I open up the TLS section, you can see here I have a certificate request portion here. And what this is doing is it's telling me, the client, hey, I gave you my certificate, now you give me your certificate. And there's a bunch of parameters here that will tell you what kind of cert you need to provide, the security parameters, that kind of thing. So what I've often seen happen is that someone is troubleshooting a TLS connection and say, you know, they give you a packet capture to look at, or you take a packet capture to look at a connection, and they are not aware that a server they're connecting to requires two-way authentication. So they use two-way TLS. So they never configure their end of the connection to send a certificate. And that is the most common problem you'll run into. It's not so much that there's issues once you're both configured, it's that one end, the client end, doesn't know that two-way TLS is being used. So here you can see a certificate request goes to the client. The client acknowledges it. And then you see here, the client, .43, sends a certificate. But when I open this up, we go down to the record layer that has a certificate in it. I'm going to open this a bit bigger. Certificate length is 0, which means we didn't actually send a cert. So what happens usually is that the client will respond to the server when it's requesting two-way TLS, even if it doesn't have a matching certificate for the site, but it will just send nothing. It'll send certificate length 0. And you'll see what happens right after. We see exchange cipher spec, some application data, which really isn't application data, because right away you get an encrypted alert, and the connection is terminated. Okay. There's different ways that the close will manifest. Sometimes the close will happen right after a certificate comes in. But really, the one thing you should be looking out for, or the two things, One is that, is there a certificate request coming in from the server? And two, am I actually sending a certificate back, or is the client actually sending a certificate back? And if you see certificate length zero, that means that is most likely your problem. So now we're going to switch gears a bit, and I'm going to show you what it looks like. All right, so this is a capture. I went and actually installed the certificate. If you go to the Bad SSL site, they actually provide the certificates that you can actually use for testing, and you can do the same thing yourself. Put the certificate in, take it out, do some captures. So same sequence of events, three-way handshake, client hello, server hello, certificate from the server, certificate request. Let's look at the certificate here. Did we actually send one? And the answer is yes. The length is now 1,188 bytes. And you can see this looks just like a certificate from the server side, right? You've got the signature, the issuer, the validity, subject, extensions, etc. So just like we did in the troubleshooting TLS video, you can go through these parameters, make sure the certificate is still valid, make sure that the subject is matching what it should be, signatures, etc. But let's look at what happens after. We have a certificate. It is valid. It's acknowledged. There's one change cipher spec. There's the other change cipher spec. Remember, that's generally the end of the TLS handshake. And then you actually have data. Now, I'm looking at everything for this IP. I just want this TCP stream. So I'm going to right click, apply as a filter. Selected. Oh, no, that's just the IP. Hold on one sec. We're actually going to open this up. We're going to go down to the TCP layer. Apply as a filter. Selected. Oh, no, that's wrong. Let's apply the port. Apply as a filter. Selected. I'm going to change out the port. We get everything. There we are. So, after the change cipher specs go through, there's a bunch of data transferred back and forth, letting you know that the handshake was actually successful. Now remember, a lot of times you're going to be looking at captures that are taken by someone else or on an appliance you don't own or have access to. And so even though you can do this testing using other means, if you can actually look at a packet capture, figure out its TLS, troubleshoot the TLS, and then figure out, oh, it's a client or two-way SSL problem, and then figure out, hey, you just need to install the cert, that will save you a lot of hassle, especially when you run into those problems. That's it for this video. I hope you found this video useful. If so, please like and subscribe. Also, if you have an issue that you're working on and you would like to review the capture on the channel or get some advice, feel free to post a link to it below with the description, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Until next time.